Welcome to another episode of What I Learned from Bobby Hemmett. And I want to try to talk about celebrity sacrifices, black celebrity sacrifices. I have spoken about this before, and I'm trying to say something again. So, you can insert any name. I am not making a specific audio for a specific person. I want to send out general information. You know, this week, so-and-so got sacrificed. Or, according to the news, they quote-unquote died. Now, the thing is, let me think of how I'm going to approach this. At what age do you think people would die? Black people. At what age do you think black people die? Like, of natural causes. Just answer that. When they're maybe, they could live up to 90, right? I mean, if you, right now, how old is your grandma? How old was her mother? Was your great-grandma? So, put that in perspective. I am from a different generation, so the most current generation now, their grandmas are probably very young because the people are having children like when they're a teenager. So maybe they haven't seen an old grandma, you know? But just put that card on the table and think about it. At what age would you expect someone to supposedly die? A black person. Number two, what are just as a normal person, we're not talking about celebrities. How do you think people supposedly die? What are some ways that people die? Like, just say you're not, just say ideally, okay? We're not talking about being in a violent environment or anything like that. Just ideally, what are some reasons for people to die? I do not think about any reason actually except natural causes. Natural causes, what does that mean? Well, for me, natural causes is because your cellular energy is low. That is why your cosmic cellular energy is too low. Also, the body starts deteriorating. However, we propagate that by what we eat in our health. So, and also everything's mental. Everything is mental. So, everything is about what is in your brain and what you've been taught. You have been taught that disease is normal and that disease will kill you and that there's Alzheimer's and that there's arthritis and all of these boogeyman things. It's an industry. It's a belief. Everything is mental. That is a very high science to understand. Everything is what you think it is. And all of our energies, the frequencies of our brains are connected. Just like the internet. So what you think matters and is connected to what somebody else thinks. That is why TV programs the mind. It programs what you think. Your brain is just an input for information. Your spirit is the one that can discern the truth or not. But most of us are spiritually dead. So we're just accepting information without spiritual discernment, without the truth. Without the truth of nature and without the truth of the universe. So put that card on the table. Now, who do we have that passed away? I just want to try to ask some questions. Who do we have that passed away? What year are they from? Like, what year are they known? Let's just say that. What year is their popularity or fame known from? Are they like a early 80s rapper? Now, are they a early 80s celebrity? Like, that was the height of their fame where they got the most exposure? And then, okay, they were known for some other shows, but the highest level was in the 80s. Now, put that card on the table. Do you see any kind of pattern with the last three black celebrities that so-called died? Are they from the same generation of fame? Put that card on the table. Now, are they somebody that is still currently famous or not? Is he or she someone that is currently famous in the limelight, has made a movie recently, has made a reboot of their TV show back in the 80s, like Will Smith? He revitalized his fame from the 90s, excuse me, by having a reunion, right? We're not going to talk about his last movie, but he's made a lot of movies. A lot of movies. And just put that card on the table. So there's a difference. There's some people, there's celebrities that are currently famous and still their name is still being spoken here and there. You know, they go on talk shows. They're linked to other people that are famous. And then there's people that were previously famous, and that stardom has left the minds of people until now they're dead. And then, or actually, let me rephrase that. They return to the black dot. They return to the source of creation. They are not dead. They have just left the effery of this world, and I say good for them. However they left, they're out of the effery of this world. So I'm just throwing out things for you to think about. Number one, don't think of them as dead. Dead? The word dead is not dead. It's D-A-R-T-H. Darth, which is another form of the word dark, which is metaphorically referring to melanin. And melanin is the, is a, it's kind of like a, it's a biological name, but it's kind of like, it's actually kind of like a fake name, because melanin is an energy. Melanin is an energy, and it happens to take a form of black. The frequency of black is melanin. They're synonymous. It's the energy of creation. Melanin is the energy of creation. Symbolically, the color for melanin is black. Euphemistically, there's a cover-up name called melanin. Biologically, they are using the word melanin to say the energy of creation. The letter M is like a sigil, I would say, a sigil or symbol for melanin. The number 13 is the numerical sigil and formula for this blackness that is biologically called melanin. In a biological form, they've given the name melanin, but it's the connection is the letter M. That is the real science of the universe, that it's the letter M and it's the number 13. Other words that start with the letter M describe the creative energy of so-called melanin. Mechanic. What does a mechanic do? A mechanic is someone who fixes things. That is what your melanin does. When you get a cut, your body heals itself. The medical killing industry doesn't heal you of anything. It only manufactures toxic chemicals and manufactures new names for imbalances in the body, and manufactures now things that will kill your melanin and turn you kill your melanin, bleach out your melanin, turn you into an albino, create people with vitiligo on purpose, because vitiligo wasn't that common before. Now it's everywhere. And also, they come up with a way to, they've studied the cell so much, they can disrupt the universal spiral cyclical orbit of the cell itself and give you and F you up with a disease that affects your nervous system or your brain, because they are disrupting the balance of the cell. The cell, every cell is spinning. It's its own universe. The word cell has EL in it. That is God energy. Anytime you have EL, that is God energy. That is the name for God energy. That's why all the angels, and it also means light. That's why all the angels have EL in their name. Gabriel, Raphael, Ariel, Michael, Azazel, Ba'el. Ba'el is an energy of light. That is also what your melanin is. It's an energy of light. Anything that is natural has an energy of light inside of it. It has the spark of creation inside of it. Anything that is natural. If it's not natural, then that spark of light is not in it. So, for GMO, the fruit or vegetable has the spark of light in the, excuse me, it doesn't have the spark of light of energy in the seed. It cannot reproduce. The seed is dead. They have figured out how to kill the damn seed. How to make it dysfunctional. They are trying to do that to melanated people. How can we destroy their seed? How can we destroy their pineal gland? How can we stop it from producing melanin? Now, you need melanin to function. Okay? It's your blood. However, there's a level of melanin. There's a level of melanin that they have found out how to control, and that's how you got a fully white Michael Jackson that turned himself albino. They figured out either he's you know what? I'm not going to say that. Well, they are studying that. What I'm saying is true. They are studying how can we kill their melanin seed. They have learned how to disrupt the cycle of the seed. That is how they can give people horrible degenerate diseases. Horrible degenerate diseases. Because they're learning how to disrupt the cell. And the cells that deal with the nervous system. So then you'll be out of control, shaking, and just lose function of your body. Put that card on the table. Going back to Michael Jackson, what I believe is that he was intravenously getting the bleaching sessions. Intravenously. So that's why he could stay as white all over. Vitiligo does not. Look, there's a difference between vitiligo and being albino. Albino, yes, you don't have any pigment whatsoever. You're white like a white wall. You don't have anything that will synthesize the light energy of the sun. You don't have anything that will convert the light energy of the sun to help you function. So the sun basically becomes like a weapon against you. Michael Jackson did that to himself. Or at least the powers that be convinced him to do that to himself. Michael Jackson got more acceptance because he looked white. He was basically a white Michael Jackson. I'm talking about in the so-called racial sense. People perceived him as white. So they loved him all the more. They loved him when he was melanated too. But I'm saying in future tense, they loved him more. And now what can happen in a future tense, people will believe that he was white. They're going to erase that he was ever black. Michael Jackson in the future, a future Michael Jackson, is going to be known as a white person. In the minds of future generations, because that's the picture they're going to see. And they can always lighten up pictures. They do that a lot of times. For the great outstanding musicians that are the founders of jazz and rock and all kinds of things, they always have their picture in black and white, and they can always, you never know what color they really are, and you can always lighten it up. You can always lighten up the color. So even your historical people, you don't ever see their real skin color. Even if you saw a color picture, but most of those pictures are black and white. So anyway, that's another point. So again, now we have, you can just fill in the blank. Who's getting sacrificed? When did they get sacrificed? Is it a full moon? Is it a winter? Is it a summer, winter, fall, spring? Is it on a solstice? Is it on an equinox? Is it on a full moon? Is it on an eclipse? Is it near a holiday? The week of a holiday, or the week before or after a holiday? Because holidays, actually, the day that you're given this fake holiday, this Mickey Mouse nonsense of a holiday, that isn't the exact day. It's a season. The holiday is not a day. For the ancients, it's a season. And it has to do with the energies of the planets, which are celestial bodies of higher gods that govern the universe. They govern the magnetic fields of the universe. And a magnetic field is just energy, but it's a magnetism. It's what's keeping things together. It is what is keeping things together, material things held together on a cellular level. That is magnetism. That's one application of magnetism. The other application of magnetism is just that it's a frequency, it's a message. It's a frequency that sends out a message. Whether it's your voice, whether it's an emotion, whether it is music, that is what a frequency is. So, how can I wrap this up now? I'm trying to get you to expand your thinking to apply to the universe more. Because the black celebrity deaths, they are sacrifices. And there's a level of evil that you don't even know exists. Maybe some of you don't know that it exists. if you look in the news, okay, and you hear about black children missing, someone getting their organs taken out, any kind of just horribleness. If you look on Google, melanin pills are being sold, and they're being used for everything. They're being used to give people a good feeling. They're being used for depression. I just happened to see something on YouTube. I didn't open the video, but it was advertising, I take melanin pills for depression. There, you cannot create melanin in a lab because it is the natural creative energy of creation, and it's found in the body of black people. And there's a spiritual aspect to it. An animal doesn't have the spiritual level that a human being has. So if anyone tries to say they're getting it from animals, that is false and a lie, and it's not the truth of the universe. So I'm just here to tell you that there is evilness, and I don't want to use the word evil, but there is things happening to you as a black person that you are likely not to know the level of it. So, killing you for your melanin is at an industry level. It's an industry. Every part of you is of value, down to your bones and teeth. And I can give you an example, not specifically, but there was a African leader that was assassinated, and his bones and teeth were kept by the European beast for a long time, until just recently they returned his remains back to the homeland. But ask yourself, why did they keep his bones and teeth? I just told you, every part of your body has a spiritual value. Your existence, your black existence, is the ingredients of the universe, the origin of the universe, and the fabric of creation. And that means that you can create with it. You could do alchemy with it. And just as they're doing, you could make medicines. They're using your energy to make themselves brown people, to make their skin brown. But they have to keep taking the pills. It won't last because they're not producing what will make their skin brown and what will give them the powers that you have. and of the powers that you don't know about. So I'm talking a little bit of this and that, and I hope that someone wakes up and the biggest thing that you need to wake up to, which I don't want to start talking about it, but you got to break out of religion, because a lot of people that are watching this, a lot of people that are watching the sacrifices or the channels about sacrifices, they agree and they say, oh yeah, this is happening, you're right. But the thing is, they're not getting the bigger meaning of it. They're not waking up to the truth. And the truth is that if you are the fabric of creation, there is no God. You are God incarnate just by being a creator. But you're more than a creator. You are an operator and destroyer as well. But you need to learn those powers. So I'm just going to say this again. If you understand about melanin, you need to expand your understanding to know that outer space is melanin. And creation came from that point. And out of the, what is it? So the Bible says before out of the darkness came a light. Before there was nothing but blackness or something, and then out of creation came a light. You are that light. You are that light. You are the Christ. You are the angle of light. You have an angle of light. A spark. Microscopically, cosmically, inside of you. That is your soul. Jesus is a fake character. If you researched, you could actually know that historically in historical books. I challenge you to research. And you know, this is the biggest challenge. I challenge you to ask yourself for the truth. Ask yourself for the truth. Say, I want to know the truth about Jesus. I want to know I want to see an effect of Jesus. Because the thing is, what you attribute to Jesus is your own power, your own belief. I'm going to wrap this up now. I hope someone caught something that I've said. And you are the Jedi Master. You are the Sleeping Buddha. And no matter how many black people they want to sacrifice, your energy never dies. It only It only has a regeneration and rebirth. And all they're doing is adding, they're increasing the energy for consciousness. Because hopefully when you leave this body, you get some level of consciousness just by leaving the body. Hopefully. And I think that we're at a point where black celebrities know, they know what's going on. And I would like to think that these black celebrities, although they are told, I don't know if the older ones have been told, but these new celebrities, they know the science of the universe. They know that they're gods. Maybe that's why they're killing the older ones. The newer ones, they know the science. They know that they're gods. They know the symbolisms. They know the symbols and colors and what everything means. They know that we are living in Disneyland and that everything is magical and that you are like a wizard and all you have to do is use the ingredients of energies around you, even as material objects, and put your intention on it and then you can manifest what you want. And they know that music is a direct frequency into your psyche. Music melts into your frequency, so it becomes a part of you. It's something that's unforgettable. You might forget the words, but once upon a time, that shit's gonna pop up in your head without you trying. Music stays with you. Even if you temporarily forget the words, it will come to you again. The sound, the vibration, the frequency, all of a sudden you will think of a song and you'll be able to replay that song in your mind. That is why music is so powerful, and that is why they control black people, to control the music industry, to control the psyche of people and to influence them to be more degenerate, to be more low vibrational, to be more material minded. And when I say that, I mean like you're only thinking about XX and eating and how you look. So you're not developing your higher consciousness to understand spiritual things so that you can tap into your spiritual powers. So, I have said a lot of different things. I wish for you consciousness, and I declare that by the power of the understanding, overstanding of who I know that I am as a God, anyone that's listening will increase in consciousness at whatever level they're at. And for whomever, whatever black celebrity that has been sacrificed in the past 2 weeks, and this is something, every 2 weeks you're going to get somebody, just know that they have returned to the source of creation. They have returned back to their light body. They have returned back to the astral plane. And there's levels in the astral plane. So whatever your level of consciousness of how you whatever level you died at, you're going to go to that level. You want to go to higher levels. The ancestors and the gods that governed the universe and the gods that governed the different astral planes, they are going to help you cleanse yourself of the memory of being down here so that you can reach your godhood. That is what I have deduced from what I read. Because ultimately, you're going to be a star. Ultimately, your ancestors are the stars in the skies. That is their soul. That is their light body. That is the power of light that's inside their pineal gland. It actually becomes a star. Now it's up to you if you want to come back down here again. They say that you chose to come back down here. Well, I guess you do that unconsciously. Because if I was conscious, ain't no way I'm coming back down here. Meaning to incarnate, reincarnate back on the earth plane, which would mean that you start as a baby again. But, you know, whatever's happening to these black celebrities, not whatever is happening to them, they have been butchered. I'm sorry to tell you that. They are no different than the no-name person on the street that you hear suddenly in the newspaper as a sacrifice and their organs being taken. The same is happening to the celebrities all the more because they were projected to the world as a god. All of the psyche energy of the world looked up to that person. That increased their energy. They were brought to a high status. Everybody gives them accolades and thinks higher of them. That means they are higher just by that alone. That's why they call celebrities movie stars. That's why they call them stars. They are a false, star getting attention from the masses, but they are a tool. They are a tool for the elite to use in order to control the masses. You think somebody's wonderful and great because they have money and because they're on TV and in a movie. So you are projecting your energy and admiration and accolades and adoration and your energy outward to someone else, thinking that they are better than you, and you are not going within yourself to learn and understand that you are a god within yourself. And that is the last message I want to say for black people. Everything is a distraction for you not to look inward and understand your own self. That TV show, that reality show that very conveniently was taking place in Houston, that was a cover-up so that you could forget about how they shut down the electricity and froze people to death in Houston. Oh, let's give them a TV show. Now, what are you talking about? A TV show. You're forgetting, and we all have done that. Within 1 week, you're forgetting the thousands of people, mostly black people, that were frozen to death on purpose in Houston, and who are now basically homemade popsicle sticks for the elite to use their melanin for. I know it's very gross to say, but you need to understand the industry level that they are at for using your melanin, because they can never get enough of it. They can never get enough of it. And using your energy. So, what I said is on a very high level. I know that it's reaching your consciousness. You might not wake up to it for a little while, but I know that it's reaching your consciousness. So, for this particular video, I will just say that ends another episode of What I Learned from Bobby Hemmett.